Good morning, everyone. It's Anitha Menon from hearthealthbrainhealth.com, encouraging healthy grieving and mindful actions. Today, I thought I would talk about the art of listening. And listening is such an important ability that we have. And yet, I wonder how many people truly do listen. And so this video, I thought I would help you understand this art of listening. And the first quotation I wanted to start with is about understanding. And this is by Ralph Nichols. And this quotation says, "The most basic of all human needs is the need to understand and be understood. The best way to understand people is to listen to them." And this is such an incredible detail that we have a need to understand others and a need to be understood ourselves. And this idea is kind of understood. And yet, how do we practice this? We practice it by listening deeply, carefully, full-heartedly. And most people are so busy with whatever is going on in their minds, their preconceived ideas, judgments, opinions, experiences, all of these things that combine to give us our memory and then our knowledge base. And that's what we listen from. And it's interesting that in that, often a lot is missed in what is being expressed than what a person is actually receiving. And so I thought today would be a good time for you to think about how you listen to another. And I thought I'd give you an example of listening to a child that has something really important to share with you, really, really important. So let's say they've been saying for the last 5 minutes, "I have to tell you something," and you just see that look on their face of something really important to this child. And how would you listen to that child? You would listen fully, right? You would listen likely with full attention. Now, full attention is definitely a place that requires a discipline of not being distracted by things in your environment or things in your own mind, because often those things take away the full listening experience. And so today I thought if you can reflect on how you listen to another, so even how you listen to this video, what are the background thoughts and awarenesses in your mind that might also feed into how you hear this video? So you might think, oh, I know Hanifa, she does videos like this. So there's coming from that knowing space, and knowledge is always limited. So limited because it's based on our last experiences, our past experiences, our judgments, our opinions, our experiences, our know-it-allness. And we do know a lot. Yet in this moment, you do not know. And unless we have an open-mindedness to what is being said and am I listening to it, you won't hear it fully. And you've probably been in this experience where you've been with a person who is busy doing something, listening, and they actually feedback, oh, so that happened today. But you know that they're kind of half-hearted about it. They're kind of busy in that time. Or you're sitting with them and you're looking straight in their face and you're talking, yet they're listening to react to what you're saying, that you did that, or respond. So let's say there's been some learning and some education, and there's been, I want to respond to this. Oh, is that what happened? Now someone can say, oh, is that what happened? And it's kind of like, and then quickly go into, this is, well, this happened to me, or that same thing happened to me. And it's not really responding to understand your experience or your sharing. And this is the thing that oftentimes we can be more mindful when we're listening to a child, because we're really present in that situation. Sometimes I do know that I listen to my dog that way, which might sound funny, but it's a good practice to be able to listen to things around us. So sometimes it's nature. I find nature speaks with me, and nature will speak with you too if you're listening. Yet most of us have lost this art. So today I'd love for you to practice this. And I thought I'd also share this quotation with you by Sydney J. Harris. And it says, "The art of listening needs its highest development to listening in listening to oneself. Our most important task is to develop an ear that can really hear what we're saying." So important, right? So I'll read it again. "The art of listening needs its highest development in listening to oneself. Our most important task is to develop an ear that can really hear what we're saying." And this is interesting, right? So when we're saying in what we're thinking is responding to what someone else has said, we need to be able to hear our own minds and our own thoughts and our own judgments and experiences. So one of the most regular things that I find people talk about regularly is things about men and women. It's so women do this and men do this and guys are like this and girls are like this. And I really like to blend the feminine and masculine energies that are in all of us. They're in all of us. So then when we look at someone, we say women do this, perhaps we can be even more specific about this woman does this, this woman did this. And even that knowledge is the past knowledge. It doesn't mean that this woman is like this today or will be like this tomorrow. How is this woman right now? And this is an important way for us to understand how we communicate with others, because all of that other knowledge and knowing is not necessarily helpful in this moment. But if I'm attentive to what's being shared, it involves my full experience of attention, my full awareness of this moment, my full participation, and that takes discipline. And it's a wonderful place to be, because we really see how much is said between the lines, how much is care and compassion between the lines. And what people are used to looking for is, I wonder what they really meant by that. And so they're not looking for the good between the lines. They're looking for, how can I protect myself between the lines? And this is, again, very useful in spaces that need protection, where we actually know that we're in danger of something. We've started applying that sort of thinking to our day-to-day experiences. And if we can recognize that this mind is thinking about how to protect itself rather than be there for a space of understanding for another, we don't pull out of that pattern. So I'd love for you to think about that today. And I also wanted to finish with one more quotation. And this one is by Carly Fiorina. And it says, "You have to master not only the art of listening to your head, you must also master listening to your heart and listening to your gut." Listening to your heart and listening to your gut. And I can tell you, there's been a long time in my life for sure, and I suspect many of us, that I've listened to my head. I've been trained about learning and listening from there and speaking from there and understanding from there and then acting from there. And it's very different to listen to the heart. And, you know, we'll hear songs like this. I think there is a famous song called "Listen to Your Heart." And so important. So often we think of that as in terms of, you know, loving spaces or care and compassion. It's very true. The space of listening from that space is very different. It is love and compassion filled. The mind is more about protection. And so recognizing that difference, then there's the gut. And the gut, I really feel, is connected more to that spiritual instinct, that, I just know I've got to say this. And this, combining with the heart, combines love and compassion, combining with the mind, combines wisdom. And those are all useful for alignment of our own experience, our own experience of understanding another and understanding ourselves happens simultaneously. And this is a beautiful place to work from. Of course, I would say that meditation helps us quite a bit. And I certainly know that I've experienced this movement in myself of this different understanding, this different action, this different way of listening. And it is a beautiful space to work from, both in our personal lives and our professional lives. So today, I hope that you will practice the art of listening, where you are fully engaged, fully attentive to things that are being said to you, written to you, spoken to you, thought by you, because you're understanding yourself as well as understanding what you're hoping to understand when you're communicating. I wish you a fabulous day practicing that, and I hope you practice it every day, of course. And I hope you remember, transform your mind and transform your life. Have a great day, everyone.